Hello, Marvel Hotline.
Hi, this is Peter David, and you're listening to Marvel Hotline. Today, we're talking about X-Factor number 50. We will be wrapping up the storyline that's been running for the last year through X-Factor and what I think is going to be a very satisfying and exciting conclusion. And in keeping with the spirit of the series, I think that the last page of the book is going to have a lot of jaws dropping as we are going to be answering questions that people didn't even know they had. The nature of the story really requires a major emphasis on Madrox and Layla, since this has been a story about sequences happening in the future. Ultimately, it all comes down to there, with Cortex having been pulled back into the future by the machinations of Dr. Doom. Everything comes to a head pretty much in the future. Admittedly, the present-day cast is given somewhat short shrift in number 50, but don't worry, they'll be getting plenty of face time in issue 200. X-Factor, I believe, as a team, is a lot less insulated than the rest of the mutant world. The X-Men, all those titles, all those characters are basically living on a floating island, separate from humanity, looking down upon humanity to some degree. X-Factor, on the other hand, is on the street level, getting involved with the day-to-day problems of living in a world that has a great distrust of mutants. And yet, X-Factor is proving what the X-Men have been unable to do, that it is possible to live in the world and interact with regular human beings and not have them shouting for your head. That's because the X-Men are accessible to evil mutants, whereas X-Factor is accessible to anybody who has a problem and a checkbook, or MasterCard or Visa, and Amex. They'll be taking Amex. We want to make X-Factor the premier go-to detective agency in the Marvel Universe for anybody who needs the services of a PI. I mean, it used to be in the Marvel Universe that if anybody got into a taxi cab, you know, Moon Knight was driving it. If anybody ever needed a lawyer, they always brought in Matt Murdock. Didn't matter if it was criminal law or constitutional law or business. It didn't matter. You always got Matt Murdock. I want to have X-Factor have that sort of familiarity. You know, they are considered the go-to agency for the needs for anyone who needs a detective agency. Thanks for listening. This is Peter David speaking from Marvel, your universe.
Thanks for calling. Check back next week for more Marvel Hotline.
Marvel, your universe.